Welcome back to another storytelling session, my dear children. How have you all been? Before I start with today's story, I want to ask you all something. Can you tell me who is the natural enemy of a cobra snake? Yes, it is the mongoose. Now, can you tell me who is the natural enemy of a crab? Well, it is the crane. Cranes eat crabs, remember? Now children, can you tell me which is your favorite food or snack? Did you say pizza, burger or chocolate? Well, I love them too. They are so yummy, isn't it? Yum! But do you know which is the favorite food of a snake? Well, it is eggs or the tiny baby birds hatched from the eggs. Please remember these things, children. We will be needing these facts to understand today's story. The name of today's story is The Foolish Crane and the Mongoose. Once upon a time, there was a very big forest. This forest had a lake, and just beside the lake, there was a huge banyan tree. There lived a lot of cranes on this banyan tree. These cranes used to lay eggs often, from which little baby birds used to hatch. But none of these little baby birds were alive for more than a few hours. Do you know why? Well, there was a hollow at the foot of the tree, and a very poisonous black snake lived in that hollow. Now, children, remember what I told you about the favorite food for the snakes? Yes, it is the eggs or the little baby birds hatched from the eggs. So, this snake was eating away all the little baby birds as soon as they were hatched from the eggs. That is why the big banyan tree never had little baby cranes lived on it. There was one mama crane on this banyan tree who had lost all her baby cranes. The snake had eaten away all of her baby cranes. So, the mama crane started crying one day. She was weeping at the banks of the lake that a crab saw and heard her and went to talk to her. The crab asked the mama crane, "Why are you crying so much, auntie?" The mama crane said, "That cunning black snake who lives at the hollow of the tree has eaten away all of my children. I am such an unlucky mother. I cannot kill the snake. What else can I do other than crying?" As soon as the crab heard this, he thought, "What a lucky day is this. Cranes are the natural enemies for the crabs. If I can come up with a clever plan, I can get the black snake killed and also get the cranes destroyed. But the mama crane should not know that I want the cranes also to be killed. So, I will have to tell the plan in such a way that she will think I am helping her." Thinking this, the crab said to the crane, "Auntie, let me help you. I can tell you a plan which can get rid of the black snake and all the cranes can live happily ever after. But for that, you will have to take some fish and flesh to a burrow which is nearby and scatter it there. There lives a mongoose in that burrow who can help in killing the black snake. Then, please leave a trail of fishes all the way from the burrow to the snake's hollow. When mongoose starts following the food and reaches the snake's hollow, he will fight with the snake and kill it." Children, do you know what is breadcrumbs trail? Trail means a mark or a series of signs or objects left behind when someone walks on a path. For example, if you are going in a forest and if you cannot find the way back, you can leave small pieces of bread called as breadcrumbs all the way from where you started until where you reach. This will help you find your way back to home. All you will then need to do is follow the breadcrumbs. You can use fruits or any other object also for the same. So, the crane agreed to the crab's idea and took a few fishes at the burrow of the mongoose and scattered it at the entrance of the burrow. The crane also made a trial of fishes from the burrow of the mongoose to the snake's home. On seeing so many fishes, the mongoose was very happy to have found so much of food. It started eating the fishes and followed the trail. When the mongoose reached the hollow at the foot of the banyan tree, it saw the black snake. It immediately started fighting with the snake and killed it. After killing the snake, the mongoose saw that there were many cranes which lived on the banyan tree. It realized that it does not have to go to far places to hunt for food. So the mongoose started climbing the tree every day and killing the cranes. After a few days, all the cranes on top of the banyan tree were killed by the mongoose. The mongoose then left the banyan tree and went back to its burrow. The crab was now safe at the lake with no other animals or birds to eat it. The crab lived happily ever after. So, this finishes today's story, my dear children. So, what did we learn today? We learned that we should be very careful when we come up with a plan for a problem. The plan might solve the problem, but we should also know what will happen after the problem is solved and where the plan will take us to. Had the crane thought about the plan properly, she would have understood that mongoose will not only kill the snake but will also kill all other cranes. Hence, she could have searched for a better plan. So, did you like today's story, my dear children? If so, please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video, my dear children. Bye-bye.